Ako.
Sabihin po niyo ang pangalan niyo.
Hans Anton Tan.
Ay taos pusong nanunumpa.
Ay taos pusong nanunumpa.
Na magsasabi.
Magsasabi.
Ng katotohanan.
Ng katotohanan.
Buong katotohanan.
Buong katotohanan.
At pawang katotohanan lamang.
At pawang katotohanan lamang.
Kasihan ako ng Diyos.
Kasihan ako ng Diyos.
Please continue, Mr. Secretary.
Mr. Hans Anton Tan.
Yes, Your Honor.
Meron akong ipapakita sa'yo.
Uh-huh. Yes, Your Honor.
Na isang sworn statement.
Mr. Secretary, naipaliwanag na ba sa kanya yung immunity?
Opo, Mr. Okay. Chair. At tinanggap na raw po niya.
Thank you.
May dalawang pahina, two pages, consisting of two pages. Nothing. And mark as Exhibit P up to P-2B. Pwede bang basahin ninyo at sabihin ninyo sa kapulungan ito kung yan yung affidavit o sinumpang salaysay na sinasabi mo?
Tapos sabihin mo kung yan ba yung
affidavit. Yes, it is.
Sa sworn statement na yan ay mayroong dalawang photocopy ng pirma mo. Maaari bang pumirma kang muli dun sa dalawang pirma mo sa page 1 at saka sa page 2?
Yes, sir.
May we request that the two new signatures of the witness be marked as Exhibit 2B, 2B-2C in page 1 and Exhibit P-2D on page 2. Mr. Chair, we are offering the testimony of the witness to prove the following. That the raid conducted by the Bucor and of course by the Department of Justice happened on December 15, 2014. This coincides with the testimony of Director Magalong that they were left out when they raided the Bucor on said date. To show that the high profile inmates were transferred on that date, December 15, 2014, to give a free hand or to make Jaybee Sebastian the undisputed king of drug trade inside the Bilibid. And this happened. And this witness will also prove that there was kidnapping inside the NBP, presumably done by the NCRPO of the PNP, the Philippine National Police. That would be all, Mr. Chair, and the witness is ready.
Thank you, Mr. Secretary. We now go to witness Tan. Mr. Tan, Will you please read into the records for the benefit of the members and all of those who are viewed to this committee hearing the contents of your sinumpang salaysay or your sworn statement?
Yes, sir. I, Hans Anton Tan, of legal age, Filipino, an inmate in the New Bilibid Prison, with prison number N210P1320, after having been sworn in accordance with law, do thereby depose and say the following. I am serving a life sentence in MBP for the crime of murder. I've been here for the last 6 years since 2010. Before that, I was detained in Quezon City Jail since 2001 until my transfer to MBP. I'm a member of Sigi Sigi Commander Group under the leadership of Jaybee Sebastian. I met Judd Adrian Dera, known to us as Judd, in the afternoon of December 15, 2014, the day the NBI raided MBP maximum security and took 19 inmates. Judd called me in the afternoon through a common friend. He introduced himself as a nephew and close in security of then Secretary Lila de Lima. I declined the phone call. After 10 months, about 10 months late after, which October 2015, when I got transferred to Building 14, he reestablished contact with me. This time, he told me he is now connected with the NCRP under General Pagdilao. He came to visit me a couple of times, and I was able to introduce him to Peter Cole and J.B. Sebastian. Sometimes on March 25th, 2016, Peter Cole was visited by his niece and niece's husband. After the couple left, he received a phone call saying that they are now under the custody of NCRP Array. They claimed that though no evidence was recovered, a test by has come out positive. At first, they were demanding 5 million peso. I spoke to the man on the phone and told him we don't have that much money. Since Peter Cole cannot speak or understand Tagalog, he threatened to file charges against the couple and the companions. Jose Adrian Dera happened to call me, and I remember he is with a group, so I asked for his help. We huddled on the phone. After later that day, he called us and said that the group agreed to 1 million peso. Peter told Judd through me to pick up the said amount in one of the popular casinos in Metro Manila and to deliver it to to the alleged group to buy the freedom of Peter's niece and husband plus of that of their companion, which Judd did successfully. Later on, I found that Peter also gave Judd another 1 million peso for some other reason. In total, I found out that Peter has given Judd through around 5 million peso throughout the entire time until the senatorial election. We lost contact with Judd until after the election, just after the election. Now Judd is reported to be with Senator Lila de Lima again as her personal security guard. Record of Judd coming to see me in MBP Building 14 has been found. Peter also has proof of Judd's claiming the amount of the 1 million peso in one of the popular casinos in Metro Manila, as well as the deposit slip of the said amount to Judd's account. I also helped Judd to acquire 5 kilos of shabu during the entire campaign period. I am executing this affidavit to attest the truthfulness and veracity of the foregoing facts and circumstances.
Thank you for that, Mr. Tan. Do you want to add anything to what you had already said and is contained in this sworn statement? Anything else that you want to add to this?
No.
Nothing?
Nothing. Not this moment, sir.
Now, may I just ask you, were you coerced, were you bribed, or were you threatened in executing this sworn statement and in your coming to this committee hearing to testify?
No, I'm not, sir.
So this is voluntary on your part?
Yes, sir.
Thank you. So, Mr. Secretary,
since all witnesses have been sworn in, I think
we now call them in so that we can start with the interpellation.
That's right.
May
Mr.
I
Chair.
Request the page or the security people to usher in the four other witnesses who testified earlier, and since Mr. Tan is already here and the other resource persons are here, we can already start with the interpellation. So next on our list is Congressman Fortune, then followed by Congressman Tevez, and then
Mr. Chair, while the other witnesses are not yet around and they might be the persons who could answer the questions of Congressman Fortune, I'd like to make a manifestation from the committee, Mr. Chair. Being a member of the 16th Congress and a member also of the Committee on Justice, I look into some records and documents in coordination with our committee secretary here in relation to the manifestation or the revelation of General Magalong and that of the PDIA, which are very credible and explosive. So that based on our records in the hearings of the Committee on Justice and the 16th Congress, it appears that the Director General of the PDIA for many times had written Director Franklin Bucayo, the former Director of the Bureau of Corrections, and reiterated by a memorandum addressed to the Secretary of then Secretary of Justice, okay, Secretary De Lima, requesting for the execution of a memorandum of agreement between PDIA and Bucor in order that PDIA could address the continuing issues and concerns in the proliferations of illegal drug activities inside the prisons and the other penal colonies. And the first letter of Director Kakdak was made last April 2, 2013. This was followed up on April 10, 2014. And then another memorandum dated November 27, 2014, addressed to Secretary De Lima, requesting information on the status of the proposed MOA between PDIA and Bucor in order that PDIA will have now access and could have jurisdiction in the investigations in the proliferations of illegal drugs at the National Bilibid Prison. Now, based on the records, although it was not acted that fast, on March 25, 2015, there was already that memorandum of agreement between the Bureau of Corrections and the Philippine Drug Enforcement Agency, dated March 25, 2015. PDIA here was represented by Director Kakdak. So may I hear from the PDIA representative, after the signing of this MOA, whether PDIA had exercised over the powers and the responsibilities afforded to them as provided in this memorandum of agreement, considering that in the testimony of the PDIA representative, in that particular raid that was conducted on December 2014, PDIA was left isolated except for the use of their canine.
Mr. Chair, ano po ba yung focus natin dito? We are here to interpolate kasi po we're concentrating on sworn statements. Ito po yung gusto namin sanang unahing tanungin habang nandito po yung mga witnesses.
Hinihintay pa po natin yung mga witnesses kanya pinagbibigyan po para wag masayang
oras. Kasi baka makumpuse tayo. Merong manifestation dito, may manifestation doon. So maguguluhan na po kami
hindi
dito.
Hindi po tayo. Hayaan nyo pong problemahin po yan ng chairman.
Ayoko pong mag-problema kayo, Mr. Chair, dahil kaibigan ko po kayo. Alam nyo
kanya
naman
yun. Kanya nga po. Kanya yung Yung proceedings po natin, ipamahala niyo po sa akin na wala pa po yung mga tao, kanya pinagbibigyan po natin ng mga oras na ito. Meanwhile, the floor is with the Vice Chair Uaminal. Bago niyan, can we hear just a clarification from PIDEA kung ano na po nangyari dito sa MOA na ito?
Your Honor, after the execution of the Memorandum of Agreement between the Bureau of Corrections and the Philippine Drug Enforcement Agency, every time that there is a greyhound operation conducted in the New Bilibid Prison, Your Honor, our canine dogs are being requested. So that's our participation, Your Honor.
Well, in the Memorandum of Agreement, your participation should not only be limited to the use of your canine. You were given some sort of jurisdiction or some sort of authority to enter into the NBP for purposes in relation to your functions and mandate of the agency.
But Your Honor, insofar as PIDEA is concerned, that's what the request during greyhound operation, Your Honor, is only limited to the canine use of the in the greyhound by the New Bilibid prison, Your Honor.
Yeah, but this MOA was already entered after the raid. So we would like to know whether your agency has complied or has done your duties and responsibilities as provided in this Memorandum of Agreement. Because the last statement that we heard from you is that PIDEA, considering the absence of this Memorandum of Agreement, has not been into the jurisdiction of looking into the proliferations of illegal drug activities in the National Bilibid Prison.